I am, you know, I want to welcome our YouTube viewers. That's perfect. Thank you, Cecil. I want to welcome our YouTube viewers. I started you up early. In fact, while I was cleaning the room on the while I was cleaning the room on the preview, I was actually embossing. So now that our YouTube viewers are in here, and we have Gene down there in Sacramento, and the dog, yeah, he was coming up here a little bit, so we have to have him outside. You know, that's always best. But anyway, new glasses. I hope you like these, because these are the everyday glasses. Oh my goodness, Sacramento is really being represented here, because there's Amanda, and you know, and Amanda and Gene know each other, and they know each other through me, because we used to all stamp together, and now we just do things online, right? So anyway, and Linda, oh my goodness, I didn't wear the, Linda sent me, well, she sent the dog a gift too, and you've seen his little Christmas scarf, but she sent me the fabulous apron with multicolored paws on it, and I guess I'm gonna have to start wearing that the first of the year, okay? So because anyway, the new computer glasses are coming in, and they're only open for another 54 minutes, and I'd like to get them so that I'm used to them by the next time that we're on. But these yeah, later for these. You know what it's like getting used to progressive. So anyway, before we get started, I do want to remind you that this is going away, and you want to look in the clearance rack, and on the dog's blog, we put posts in there, or we put links in there to, you know, the things that are still available, because one of the things that I would definitely get, and, you know, you could use this in January, and you could use it next year, too, because it makes such a simple Christmas card. I don't even have to show you a sample to see that, you know, emboss that, put a nice big stone in the middle, put a greeting at the bottom, whoop, good, you are good to go. Did you get that card from me? So anyway, I am so glad you're here. The other thing you want to stock up on is foil snowflakes. This foil snowflakes are going away, and I only have silver in this pack, but they come in silver and gold, and if you want to, in case you didn't know, you can turn them over and color them with, I would think, a marker. I haven't done this. I know you can sponge it. I know that I would think a marker would work. I don't know that I would want to use a really good marker necessarily. I'd rather sponge it, because all those edges would go and, you know, it would tear up your marker. And of course, I'm going to show you my, you know, I showed you my favorite Christmas card, one of my favorite Christmas cards, the one I kept, right? And look at, this is the one that Marcy sent me, made with the same thing. And, you know, neither one of them are really involved, but on hers, the only thing that's going away is the ribbon and the greeting, and on mine, pretty much everything except for the vellum, like the washi tape, you know. So anyway, I hope you can see those. So how are you doing today? I mean, are you ready for me to start showing you stuff? I don't, you know, I really don't like to, like, sit here and, you know, do a walking commercial for the first 10 minutes. Usually I just dive right in. And you know, on the Stamparatus, today is the last day that you can pre-order yours. Otherwise, you're going to have to wait until January. No, not January. You're going to have to wait until June. You know, that other J word. So, hey, is anybody doing anything? Oh, hey, great, Brenda. You are going to love it. So let's get started, because I can only do like about 30 minutes. And, you know, here I just love to do things. I was so excited yesterday about getting started with this that, that, you know, I just wasn't thinking. You know, I wasn't thinking. And, you know, I have one of these already done up. And do I know what happened to it? No. So this is one of the new sets from the new Occasions catalog. By the way, golly, here I said I wasn't going to like do a whole bunch of commercials, but you know, if we just get this out of the way, I mean, I just want to make sure that you are taken care of. Now, you should have had, if you're an active client of mine, you should have gotten, hey, Karen, Karen's here from Florida. So anyway, you should have gotten one of these in the mail. I mean, I would go out and look. I'm mailing one out to someone new who ordered yesterday. I know that. Anyway, inside you will find the Occasions catalog. That I can't show you the inside of, and the Celebration catalog, and this flower is from, and the Brusho is from the Occasions catalog, and then when you spend $50, you can get something free out of the Celebration catalog. But what is new this year, and if you receive one of these in the mail from me, type yes, is that there are some things that you can get for, you know, free for $100. And, you know, it's the top of the line stuff. Okay, Lynn and Karen are here from Canada. Yay! And Karen says that it is, oh, you're going to love this. For those of you who are on, you know, on YouTube, you can't see all the comments from Facebook, and Facebook can't see all the comments from YouTube. And so, and I should be receiving both. I'm not sure about, you know, YouTube doesn't always agree with me. I don't know what it is. They just don't realize how wonderful we are. Anyway, and how much we need to talk. Anyway, so there's some things in here that are new this year that you can get free with a $100 purchase, like some really nice framelits and a really great greeting set. And then, hey, if you're really looking to change your life, hey, this changed mine. This is, just ask for one of these. I will be glad to send you one. If you have any questions about joining my team, believe me, it is a life changer. I have lots of my pup club people end up joining my team, and I love it. And hey, there's Marcy. Marcy's on my team. And anyway, let me get started. I did have, this one is going out for all of you hoarders. Who's a hoarder? If you are a hoarder, or are you a neatnik, you know, that's okay. You can claim your fame right now. Because if you're a hoarder, it could help. Oh, yes, Krista's here and Amy's over there. Oh, my goodness. Since we're doing weather reports, here, Amy's over there in Maryland, and it is 31 degrees. Hey, you know what? That's how much it gets here at night. So welcome, welcome, welcome. I am so glad you're here. So here we go. First of all, I used the embossing buddy over this, and then I went and this is my poorest embossing I've ever done in my, well, life, because it's not, oh golly, I didn't even, let me tap that really quick. I was doing it just as the introduction was playing, and that's a little bit powdery, and it may never, nope, it's not going to. I don't think it's going to. Oh, it's better. So for this first one, we're just gonna go and take this. Now you want to cut, they do recommend that you cut the paper, the cardstock, a little bit. Yes. I will take honorary members. Yes, I will take honorary members. Yes, actually, Amy is on my technology team. She's really smart that way. She's on my technology team, and I appreciate her so much. Oh my goodness. And Linda says that it is zero where she's at. So anyway, I got to get this done. So You're going to go and use embossing buddy, then stamp in white, and then stamp with white, or emboss with white powder over it. And then I got this on Amazon. They probably have it down at your hardware store, but you know, that just doesn't work for me. So I'm going to tape this down because I'm going to spray it a lot. If I don't get those glasses today, it won't be the end of the world. But I do have a, you're going to love this. I do have a, two swaps that have to go in the mail today. Now that's a bit of a wide border, so I guess I would be cutting it down a little bit thinner. Now those of you who get my reminders so that you know that the we're going on, you'll get a minute or two before we start. I noticed that when that those go to your those don't take you to, if you have the Facebook app on your phone, they don't take you to the app. They take you to the site. And, you know, that's just, I don't think they've got their technology all the way up. So, back to the thing. No, now, nobody's, okay, at least Karen is pleading the fifth on this, right? I did ask you, who's a neatnik and who's a hoarder? Because there's plus and minuses of both of them. Believe me, as long as it's not getting in the way of your relationships and you're not getting sick, you know, I mean, whatever is good for you is good for me. So I'm going to put this down, and you notice it's already a little warped already. But that's okay. That's okay. The reason why I said is because what this is a... one of those inserts from the back of the specialty designer paper. I try not to hoard too much. Anyone who's seen my stamp room is probably laughing right now. Anyway, but these I do hoard because I use them when I send out the sweet treats. I wrap things around them. Not so much this one as the one that's white on one side and not on the other. Oh, Linda. Okay, definitely a hoarder. Okay, Paula, when you say you lost me, where'd you lost me? Nope, it's still going on out there. So anyway, so there you go. I've got this down. Now, this is Sahara sand, and it gives you a little bit of, a little bit of contrast. It'll take more water than the... regular white paper, and less water than watercolor paper. Okay, and see, I've got one of our little spritzers here that I have reminded myself that that's not alcohol. Don't drink it. Or actually, I can drink this because it's water. Now I'm using this to help me keep my area a little bit better because I can always wipe this off. This is real wood, and it's not seen. Sealed under here, and I'm going to spray this. Now, if you're wondering what we're up to today, because I haven't even talked about that. Golly. I don't think I'm getting those glasses today. What do you think? Okay, just when I was thinking this morning, I was like, oh, you know, no major issues yesterday. That is great. You know, everything went smooth and even. And then all of a sudden, yes, I've done everything. You know, you're typing now that yes, no sound, and I see that. I even checked my sound when the music was going, and you know, the sound, you know, the bar was showing that there was, you know, noise, so I assumed it was me. No. No, I know you can see me now, even though right now I'm reading that you can't see me. So anyway. Oh, golly. Maybe I need to, like, use a stapler and just go staple myself, you know? Let me staple my hair on or something. I don't know. Okay, so now that we're back, I'm going to go spritz this some more. Because I'm going to spritz this more. I think I would like to try this with... I'd like to try this with... with alcohol, because alcohol dries faster, but you don't want it to dry fast. Okay, I'm glad you're here because you missed all the fun. Okay, so when you do not open these when you get them. Don't open these. Just go and take a push pin. Doesn't have to be a fancy push pin like this, and just pierce it in there, and that's good enough, okay? Because all you're going to do is shake it. There, I've got... Can you see where I've got... I'm going to learn to aim better. And now I'm going to put that back in there. You don't have to do it that fast, but hey. Just be careful when you pull these out, you know. Don't poke yourself. Yeah, Amy, you know, you have to have a good... I'm going to shake that up. You have to have a good sense of humor for this, because... You know, I love being my own cameraman and producer, artist, dog lover, you name it. So thank you for hanging in there with me. I just love it that you... Boy, this almost seems like it needs two. I'm going to put the top back on. I'm going to put the top back on, and I'm going to shake it a little bit. Maybe it's kind of... in a clump down there. There we go. You know what might be good? I just got some electric salt shakers. You know, not shakers, but this is not for those of you who want everything exactly within the line, because it just doesn't work like that. And see, I think I'm, you know, punching it over here, but I'm not. I'm, you know, it could be landing anywhere, and I guess I just have to learn how to shake that thing, you know. Shake your money maker. Okay, so this is the green, and I'll just put a little bit over here. Oh, hey, I actually hit it. And you're not going to see anything with this today so much as just to give you an idea of how it works. See, green, because you can touch it up with your... hold on, aqua painter, but you have to be sure to clean it in between colors. Like if I was real, you know, getting tired of not getting it in there, I could go and spread it around this way. You know, just say, oh, I'm tired of shaking, I'm not getting it in there. And now I'm going to do that. And I, of course, the paper towels are over there. So I'll just leave there. That's green. So you can move this around. Here, I'm going to take some of this red over here, and I'm just going to move it over here. This is just to give you an idea. Because they tell you that it has to be a certain way, doesn't mean that it has to. You can go and try things, but you'll notice that if you can see it from the side, I can't really pull that up, but this is really poofing up. But by just leaving it here until it dries, it's going to straighten out. And I'm going to get... What do you think about that? Is that like a science project? I'm going to show you something else. First, I'm going to get some paper towels here. And if I was really, you know, you really need to give this a chance. Give this a chance to work, because it's going to get more intense the longer it sits there. And so if I start blotting it now, it could go lighter. I mean, I could be going and putting maybe orange or blue around the edge if I wanted to. This might totally ruin it for all I know, you know. Put a little bit of a background around the edge. It's an artsy fartsy thing. It's for those of you who like, you know, like to try something new. It just kind of spreads. But it doesn't have to be that way either. I'm going to show you something else. This is just to... You'll have to come back to the dog's blog to figure out, to see what, how it ends up, because, you know, I can't do it all today, or else we'd be sitting here, you know, waiting for paint to dry. Literally. Now, here, I don't like that. Look at, I got some of the blue in there, so I'm going to try... Look at... Whoa. See, I put too much blue. Whoa. Maybe now I'll go in this, but I'm going to go and mop this up because it's awfully wet. And you could tap that with a heat tool, hair dryer. You know, if you're seeing something that you like, you know, give us a thumbs up over on Facebook or over on YouTube, or give us a a thumbs up over on Facebook, and that helps Facebook know that, you know, I should do this again. Look at, I got this wet. So here, let's see what's next. Here, I'm going to do one more here. You're going to get an idea. Maybe there's an idea popping in your head. Yeah, that blue is awesome. See, now these are just quarter sheets, and you know, if it all turns out the way you like it, if you've been careful to put your borders on fairly straight, not like I'm doing now, right? If you then you could just use this, and you could don't have to do thin borders. You could do wide borders. I'm always trying to think, you know, am I going to get the, you know, I want to get the most use out of it. Like that other one, I might just cut that flower right out of there. The other thing, oh, hey, we have a few people that like the blue background. I kind of like it too. It just gave it a lot of contrast. This is easier to rip off than I make it look. And oh great, this is the one with no water in it. Okay. Back to, you know, I did mention cleaning these. Which one has the most water? It's not like I don't have a ton of these. But see, you just go and wipe it on here until it goes away. You know, the color goes away. Then you know you can... Otherwise, you're going to get interesting. Like if you get blue and red together, what color do we get? That is purple. So, see, I was hoping to just go in... This is more of a controlled burn here, a controlled painting situation. And I'm not there. Trying to get it as even as possible, but there's going to be streaks. So I would think, now remember, I'm just making a background. I'm not doing, and since you like the blue, let's go with that. Let's see, I would say blue up at this end. No. Gotta, you know, get your wrists going. Really, really active. Now, a sunset. What would a sunset be? Red next, then yellow down at the bottom? You could try, might have better luck with this going. I don't know why this red does not want to shake. And look at it shaking all down there, but that's okay. I'm going to do a couple things with this. Maybe I need to have two holes, but you know, as soon as I do that, then it'll start pouring out. This is not watercolor paper. This is our regular cardstock. Watercolor paper is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be, you're going to have a different experience with that. It will take more water. I think this will be great for a sunset card. We'll see. I don't think I put enough water on it, and it looks like I missed it right there. But I'll take care of that in a second. Oh my goodness, this is my 4th of July card. I got a ways that I, time that I can. Now, if you think that I've left a lot of area there. Hold on, let's get. You know, oh, I don't know what's going to happen now, but I'm willing to find out. Looks like I have two of these. Ho, 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 ho! Look at that. Just call me Pollock. Whoa. Whoa. And then if I want to make sure, you know, I'm making sure that this is clean, right? And then I can just go in. Smush it around a little bit, but the more I smush it around, the less, you know, like lava that it's going to look. So, hey, you know, yes, this is a spray bottle. This is one of the Stampin' Up! Spray bottles that you can get. You could get like something, what I have been using in the past, and I'm talking about long time ago in the past, is like something you get in the travel section. It's a bottle maybe that big and maybe this big around, right? And but I find that it doesn't have as directed a it doesn't direct the spray as much. This I get a much more direct spray to where I'm going. But if you could see this from the side, now see if I can help you with that. I do want to get that big blot up. You do have to give it time to react, okay? So those of you who are hoarders, see? Okay, here's our resident art enthusiast, our technology department. That is great. Hey, and that's cool too. I want everybody to tell me how you think, you know. But if you look at this from the side, this is like puffed up. See, look at how it's puffed up. But what happened last time was that I came back later and like the next day I tapped it a little bit with the low setting on the heat tool, and it just went back down. And when I finally took this off, and what I like about this frog tape, even better than the blue painter's tape, is that, and because this is a type of painter's tape, and I'll show you the lid to that again. And I got the yellow one. They have several of them. I think this was $7. If you know, I'm not sure, because I bought it like over a month ago, and you know, I've slept since then. It did not stick to the paper, and I really appreciated that. So, hold on, Karen. What's Karen Hetzel get? Okay, that's K. Hold on. Oh yeah, that would be cool. Just yeah, if I picked it up so it all ran down. I don't want to run down into each other. It's kind of the way it is anyway, but wait till you see what I'm going to do next with it. You're going to have to go to the dog's blog later this week. It'll probably be at least Tuesday or Wednesday, because Wednesday, the new the catalog that you can buy this in is out on Wednesday, and it'll be Wednesday afternoon. And oh my goodness, don't you know that that is when we go and meet again? So every Wednesday at 1 o'clock Pacific time. So it's the same time as this. And honestly, I have to tell you, I am thinking of moving it later, a little later, only because this is a good time for me. But the night before, I am so excited to go and meet you that, you know, and meet with you that I just don't sleep well. I went to bed at 5 o'clock this morning because I'm going, okay, do I have this done? Do I have this done? And you know, you know that I never have it all done, okay? So if you want to be reminded for our next time, and that is next Wednesday, and then make sure you type stamp in the bottom, and we'll send you. Now, that works with Facebook, right? That's only works on Facebook. You go over into the comments, just type stamp, and you will be able to be reminded of when we meet again. And you know, I'll show you another thing that kept me up this morning. Hold on, where is it? Okay, I guess I'm not. I had them all here, but I'll give you a hint. This is the centerpiece of it. We have to finish these swaps, and that's the centerpiece. And I'm going to be putting a little bit of Wink of Stella right here on the envelope. So, you know, that'll be cool. We've got 35 of them done. Mr. Clemmer has been outside. He has been scoring and folding for me. And so, hey, and you know, what if there was a way that I could give you like 24 project tutorials a year? I can give you more than that, but 24 at least, right? Those of you who are on my mailing list, really, you've already gotten like the 12 weeks of Christmas, and that's fine, but you know, we've got a new catalog coming out and new ideas to play with, and maybe I'll feature this and on how to do it, or you know, maybe something else. So if you're not on my mailing list and you want to get on my mailing list and get at least 24 project tutorials in your inbox over the year, then you want to type mail below, and guess what, then I'll also remind you about the events, but live events, but it doesn't turn the other way around. So hey, I thank you so very much. And oh, by the way, when you, if you've typed stamp or if you've typed mail, make sure you follow the directions, because the dog goes and, you know, asks you a couple questions that, like, you know, do you really want this? And the answer is yes. Now hey, I would go and bring the dog in right now, but I have 21 minutes to go get those glasses, and we'll see if that makes me any smarter. I am so glad that you have shared this, that you have stuck with me through this. God bless you. And if this is the last time I talk to you this year, I hope it's been a great year. I hope your next year is going to be even better. How about that? So God bless you. If you have any questions, contact me on the dog's blog or here on Facebook, or you can even leave a nice comment on YouTube. And if you didn't like it, well, I'm sorry. We'll try better next time. God bless.